Oh, look what I see. An unwelcome visitor. A zombie pigman from the nether. How he got here, I don't know. But, wrong weapon. This is the one I need. A grave sacrifice. And an enderman, I think. Yeah. If I can get him, it could be excellent. Probably could kill him with one hit too, shall we? Yeah. Oh yeah, good. That's the advantage of being near the altar. Hopefully I haven't excited all the zombie pigmen in the nether. We shall find out. So, next part of the quest is to make an air sigil. So that's made with 6 blank slates, 1 gas tier, 1 weak blood orb, and 1 piece of glass. So that should be fairly straightforward to do. Recipe for those is 1,000, so we need 6,000 in the tier 1 altar. We should be able to do that very quickly, because we should have over there enough. We've got plenty of stone. 6 stone. Put it in the hopper. Oh, that's what I mean. Blood orb is. I want the weak blood orb. And I have to take the other blood orb out of there. We've got the gas tier. And for some reason, they're not going into the altar. I don't know why it does that sometimes. Actually, I need to change this. Let's have a look. Before I go and do that, let's kill a few mobs. My printer's being a bit noisy as well. Right, what did I want to do? I want the crescent hammer, don't I? And the crescent hammer is back here. The reason I want the crescent hammer is so I can hit the hopper and change its location. Sometimes maybe I just to break it, and that one I've now got sucked up by the vacuum hopper and put into this chest. And let's put it back down again on here and see if the stone this time goes in. Now you can see the hopper's pointing the wrong direction, so let's now make it go to the right direction, I think. This looks right. Let's just check which direction it's pointing in. That must be the right direction. Yes, this time it works. It's very strange when it does that. So we can just wait here now until that's made, because we've got everything else we need, I think. Another skeleton. Get a bit nearer. Hit him a bit nearer. In fact, you can just about see in there. There's a creeper over there. I could get him excited by hitting him with a bow and arrow, but I don't want him to see me. And I left the bow and arrows at the back in the nether anyway. So while that's cooking, let's go and get the divination signal. I think it's somewhere about. It's probably in. Let me throw it through this chest here. Yes, my divination signal. So this should have about 4,000 LP when this is cooked. Oh, there it is. Already done. This time it's put a bone in there, I think. Take that out as well. Okay. And we come back again and we shall now finish off this quest. Get a bit of tree in the way. So it was 1 weak blood orb, I think is here. 1 piece of glass, which I don't see, maybe I have to make some. Oh, I have to make some. What a nuisance. So, if I'm right, that's just gunpowder and cobblestone. Let's take a few cobblestone out of here. And I need to put the orb on it. So, we've got four gunpowders. That was gravel, wasn't it? So, we need to put this orb, will do. Yes. And there we get some sand. Let's go and cook the sand while we're thinking about it. Get one piece of glass, and it'll be quite quick. So what was the pattern there? It was six slates. Oops. Like this. One gas tier and one piece of glass, I think. Oops. That's a piece of glass. And we have one air sigil. The air sigil then has to be joined to me. Let's go and check the quest book. I've got two quest books on me, I don't need those two. 100% claim rewards, iron boots selected. Spirits in the air. Let's have a quick look. Feather falling 5, unbreaking 1. That are excellent boots for the air sigil. Because let's have a look. Oh, by the way, I got some necrotic bones and a weather skeleton skull from the nether and some coal from killing some more nether weather skeletons. But I'll put those away because I don't want to carry those around with me. Coal might be useful. Let's leave it in here for the time being. Any more hearts? I only have a half of heart. Him in here, and one book, we don't need that. Two books, let's just sort this, and I'll call that a day. Oh, yes, I haven't showed you the air sigil, so we have to join it to me. Oh, like that, it's already joined. And as you click it, it takes you up. And to land, you actually flick it down again. Oops, that was close, I nearly fell off. And you actually hit, you right click it onto the target you land it, trying to land on. But it's very fast, so it's quite hard to do. Let's get this enderman, and I got another ender pearl. A lot of them in there, aren't there, today? I'll leave them for the time being, because there's another quest I can go down to that straight away. I reckon this first quest should have unclaimed rewards. Oh, no, not yet. 3 days. Oh, maybe I can claim it. Oh no, not quite. 2. Kill 5 more zombies, I think. There's plenty of zombies in there. Is it zombie I had to kill? Let's check again. Yes, 3. And there's definitely another zombie in there. That was good hitting them with whatever I had in my hand. Okay, until next time. Now we'll have a look at the quest book just before I go. Back to Lady of Sorrow, Skylands and Turnstiles. 6 quests available for completion. So here we have the basics of life. And here I have to make a water sigil. I got 4 reward bags, that's good. Here I have to make an enderly seed. And I get another half and heart, which is excellent. And here we have to get 1 bucket of life, which unlocks the witchery chain. And this one, unlock 1 bucket of water, unlocks the pneumatic craft chain. Okay. I have to think about which way I want to go. Until next time, bye for now. Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to Running Red, the Minecraft hardcore questing mod from Gideon Seymour. Now, there's a few noisy mobs here. I'm just going to pick up these. I moved the vines, by the way, from... Let me just get rid of these. They're making too much noise. I can't hear what I'm saying. That's a bit better, I think. I've got Oh no. Enderman. Good. That's it. Right. And as you can see, I moved the vines planted at the top here, and they've already grown all the way down. So we'll just cut a few more of these off. And maybe plant them up here somewhere. Yes, I can just about do it. Get it just right. And they'll eventually go down. I'll get back to killing a few more of these mobs. Still another zombie in there somewhere. Oh, look. Actually, I do need a lot of mobs, because of the next one of the next quests to do is to make a upgrade the altar again to tier 3. Now, oh look, a beech tree, and here's a spruce tree. I haven't shown you how to do that. I'll show you that in a minute. So the first thing is to go back to the quest book, and actually I've got a reward back here. Let's have a look. What did I get? 4 florbs. This was from the repeatable quest. Let's put those 4 florbs away, and I've got a notch apple and some more copper aubrey bushes and the diamond. So I have a choice of doing the witchery chain or doing the pneumatic craft chain, and I've been deciding I'm going to do the pneumatic craft, mainly because everybody else that's done their videos on Running Red have always chose the witchery chain, so I think I'll just be different. Let's gather the food. I need to get a farm up set up pretty early. So let's have a look at the quests we've got on hand here. So I want to make ender pearls. I'll need ender pearls because let's select this task. And we need 4,000. And we're going to need a lot of ender pearls. More than I've got from the mob spawner at the moment. So a bucket. I need 4 buckets, I think. Yes. And here I've got a hardened chest, a reinforced portable chunk. Get some more blood into that. And the reinforced portable tank is made by putting a hardened portable tank in a blood altar. But let me just show you how to do that one. Let's have a look. So we start off with the portable tank and then the hardened portable tank, which is, we can't do this at the moment because we haven't got any inver. It's by putting a portable tank in the blood altar gives you a hardened portable tank, and the next one up it'll be the reinforced is made by putting, let's have a look, try again, uses a hardened portable tank in the blood altar tier 2 gives me a reinforced, and of course the last one along here would be the resonant, which is made by a tier 3 and 10,000. So at the moment we're only up to tier 2, so we can only make tier 2 items. But there is one other item I prepared, and I want to make that, and that is this. And I think I need a weak blood orb. Oh no, I probably don't. I need the other one. In fact, let's go and do my quest. I've got this quest selected, haven't I? Where is the quest delivery system? Oh yes, I've got to click this. Select the task, right click it. Okay, now we can put these down here. We just check the quest book quickly to make sure that we're actually doing the right quest. 75%, yes, exactly. So I'll move these two out of the way and put these three down and quickly submit these three. And I should get ender pearls. Now, where are they? the interpoles go to? Now that's a challenge, I don't know. Hopefully they haven't gone into the hopper and been submitted again. That would be a waste. I'll remove the hopper in a minute and just come back and do that. So here we have Let me take this out of the altar here and try using the apprentice blood orb to make this. What I'm going to make here is a sigil. And the sigil I'm going to make is the signal of the green grove. Now what this does, and this is really quite a useful sigil, is makes things grow. So let's go back here, put this one back in again, take out the gunpowder that's come in, put the gunpowder over there. And we'll get rid of this rotten flesh as well at the same time. So when I activate this by right clicking here, as I say, as they come to things which actually grow, it'll either act, see, like bone meal. So I right click it to get it straight away. And here I've got some carrots and some potatoes, which I shall straight away replant. And as you can see, it affects all of these things. They've all grown up very fast. And it's using life essence from the thing. But it doesn't only grow plants and melons, it also grows aubries. So just by coming in here, all of these things just start to grow. Just because I've got it activated, so I can take these off and just wait a few more seconds and I should get some more. And as you can see, I'm not sure what the range is, but it's quite effective. At the moment I really need, I will need lots and lots of iron, and that's already full. But I don't need a notch apple in here, so let's take that out, sort it again, and come over here. What else I've been doing is, let's put this notch apple away. I think I keep them in here, don't I? Yes, I do. I don't want the carrot and I don't want the vines. What else I've been doing is I've been building lots of bookshelves to allow me to do enchantment. And the first thing I enchanted was a sword. And I got a knockback 2, a smite 4, and a fire aspect 2, which is a great sword and will come in very handy when next time I go to the nether. Later on, I'll be able to disenchant this into a book, replicate the book, and make it a smite 5, maybe a knockback, remove the knockback, it might not be so useful. So let's go now and look at the quest book again. And that one's done, and I've got 4 hours. I can do it again, but I don't know where the enderpearls went. That's a bit of a pain. Just to be safe, I wonder how that does work. Let's just knock off this hopper. And let's select the quest again. Oh, claim reward. Aha. That's how it works. Silly me. It was from the book. So I can put the hopper safely back on again. Okay, got these vines, they're growing like crazy. In fact, they're growing more rapidly than the... Of course, they're growing more wildly now, and I've got this, so let's turn this off when I come here. And we'll chop down a few of these vines as well. Maybe I'll leave this entrance sort of free. Oops, chop them with the sigil. Alright. As you can see, the mob spawn is working quite happily now. And it fills up the altar very quickly. Let's hold what we got in the altar now. Divination signal, she'll tell me. I probably got about 10,000. No, 6,200. I was using quite a lot before for doing... I want to upgrade the altar to being level 3. And here we have these trees. I was going to show you about that, didn't I? So let's have a look at spruce. Here I've got a spruce sapling, and the recipe for that is one bucket of water on top of an oak sapling. And that's actually how you make them. And you can do the same here. And they have different recipes for ender stuff. And the usage of this one, another one, is you can... Nope, not telling me what I want to see yet. What did I do? What type of usage I did. So let's have a look at the beech sapling and have a recipe for this. This is one bucket of water on top of a spruce sapling. It gives you a birch sapling. Say beech, didn't I? Birch. And actually those are used later on in witchery, even though I'm not going to do witchery. So next quest, let's have a look at this. Him away, and this one here, a water sigil. We've got to make a water sigil. Let's do that first because it's a really easy one to make. Let's go over here and let's type in a sigil, and the water sigil is a blue one, so that's fairly straightforward. Just 7 buckets of water around a blank slate and a wheat blood orb. Okay, we have all of those. One blank slate. I made 50, you see, for the blood orbs. Where is some buckets? I need 7 buckets. Here we got 7 buckets. Let's go and fill those up with water. And place those around here. There is a way to actually make these move up. Something to do, I haven't figured it out yet, but I did see it on somebody else's video. And here we have one water sigil. The water sigil works exactly the same. I'm going to take that out of there because I forgot where it was last time. I made another one. The water sigil works exactly the same way as a lava sigil. So you can right click to bind it to yourself, I think. And then you just come along and you can fill in a place with water like that. And it uses LPRI from the network. Take that out. And for the sake of it, I'll just put that bucket of water away. I don't need it for the time being. But I might need some more. Okay, so we'll have to do that quest first of all. So now we can claim a reward. Eeny, miny, miny, miny. Let's take this one. Oh, I can't do it yet. Hold on. Has it not detected my water sigil? Why not? And there's no manual detect on here either. Isn't that strange? Maybe because it's owned by me. I wonder. Let's make another one that isn't owned by me. They're fairly easy to make and fairly quick, and it doesn't matter actually having two, because there's another sigil which is very, very useful, and we shall make that in a after upgrading the altar a couple of times, one blank slate to one, don't I? Yes. So, catch that one I chose, didn't I? Okay, now we put this away somewhere safe. That was very strange. And have a look at what we got in the reward bag. Well, not 100% great, but we could get another ender pearl, which is great. Oops, let's go over here. And what have we got in here? All sorts of bits and pieces. Got 6 ender pearls there. I haven't explained why I want these ender pearls yet. be nice. Oh, I also put a chunk loader here to keep the mobs spawning, even if I was in the nether. So what do we have in the vacuum hopper? Nothing, of course. So I have 15 in here, so that means I've got 22? 21. And here we have some more vines. Where are my shears? There. Fact. Well, let's put this stuff away. I don't need these. It's getting full of this chest, isn't it? I usually take the weapons out of here because they're usually interesting weapons. I did get a bow with power 1, which I repaired using the anvil. I made an anvil as well. And sometimes these are quite useful to have. So let's have a look in here. I haven't got enough space for everything, but I can do this and put these two helmets together to make almost a glowstone complete helmet. I was expecting that to be complete. What else do I have in here? A steel sword. Let's take the thorn vines out of there and put the steel sword in. I'll get another steel sword and we can do the same business. Let's put that in here if we have space. Sort that chest out as well. I'm running out of inventory space, so I shall have to do some upgrading. Anyway, let's go back to the quest book. So that was now complete. So the next one is this, the basis of death. And what we have to make is one ender lily seed. Okay, and one ender lily seed. Let's have a look at the recipe for this. Is 8 blocks of solid ender. Each solid ender is made out of 4. So we're going to need 32 ender pearls, which we haven't got yet. We've only got, we're not far off actually. Let's make as many as we can, which is 5. And what do we need in the middle of that? Was one seed. So our seeds we've got plenty of. So let's put those in this chest if we have space, which we don't. Nope, no space whatsoever. I could take these out and put those in here. Let's do that for the time being. And put those in here. Right. So I'm going to go and make some more ender seeds, ender pearls. And of course, the best way to do that at the moment is to submit them to the here. Okay, let's check the book again. Can we do this? Resets in 4 hours. Not yet. Okay. I shall see you in a short while. Like I said, to my water pool. I shall see you in a short while when I've got the ender pearls. Bye for now. Oh, hello, everybody. Back again. And I've just killed an enderman, so I now have enough ender pearls to make my 8 blocks. So I can make the 8 blocks here, put one seed in the middle, and then get one lily seed. Let's go back to the quest book, and I should have an unclaimed reward. Let's just pick any one of these two, claim reward, and let's have a look what we've got. Let's put the notch apple away and the half a heart, which is good because I now have two half hearts. And we can then quickly, let's just put those like that, get a full heart. Oh, I was going to chuck that away. Let's do that as well while I'm doing things. I want to get rid of this stone sword. I built a trash can here, so I just click it and it goes away. I'm better than leaving things lying around, that's my view. And one more heart, 15 hearts again. Lives, I mean. So, where was I up to? The quest book. So we've claimed those. Now we should have two reward bags. Oops, that's probably two reward bags. A good reward bag and a basic reward bag. So I got four more floobs. You can't see them, can you? No, I can't either, so let's put those away. They're actually rather useful, and let's have a look at this one here. 32 golden apples, that's a pretty good reward. B plus reward. So now the ender lily seed we shall plant. The best way to plant this is actually an end stone. Now let's see if we can make end stone. Endstone. Spell this differently. Here we are. End space stone. So we can use resident enter on sandstone to make, maybe that's what I would have to do. Okay, so I can't do that yet. Okay. But it's not impossible because we can get sandstone by using four sand. We'll make one sandstone. Let's have a look at the recipe book again. Right, done that one. So now I have to make a choice. There's nothing else on here. Just a second. So what we can do is one, the sharpest lives. This one here opens a witchery chain, which is the one I didn't want to do. And this one here opens pneumatic crust. So we're going to select this task, get one bucket of water, somebody's telephone ringing in the background, right, one bucket of water, and we shall submit this to the quest delivery system. Just before I do that, I'm going to do one more thing. I'm going to stop and I'm going to reload the server, because when I do that I can take a backup. So if I decide to change at some later date, we have a good place to come back to. So just a minute. Right, I'm back again. So let's get the bucket of water and submit that. Let's go back to the quest book. Yes, once you've stopped you come back again. So I've got one, where am I up to here? This is Our Lady of Sorrows, oh yes. Okay, we claim these rewards. Always a good idea to do that. And let's go and put this stuff quickly away. So the Aubreys, the diamond. Where did that go to? Let's put the bookers away. I don't think I need those for the time being. And we could plant the stones. I wonder if we can plant it on wood. Now let's have a look at the bag first. Oh, another lava crystal. Let's have a look. E. Nope, can't plant it on wood. Let's plant it on a bit of dirt. But it's not a very good thing to have around. I can't plant it on there. Alright, that's one piece of dirt. Have we got dirt in this chest? Nope. It must be over here. Dirt. One block of dirt, just fine. And I'm going to plant him round here. Somewhere like this will do fine. Pickaxe. Take this one out here. Put the dirt down here. And plant the lily seed on top of it. There we go. More melons. They're coming in very fast. Right. quest book again, just before I go, that is, because it's time again, I think. What has happened here? 4 quests available for completion. Open. Have I not done that one? Oh. Yes. I didn't click the book on here, did I? And I do need a bucket. Going crazy. Just hasn't gone away, let's have a look. Manual submit. Can I not select the task? Let's try that again. Something's not working as it should do. Some melons in the water, let's pick those up. Back to the book. Right, here we go. So now I can claim all the reward. That's a bit strange. Didn't behave as it was supposed to do. And here I've got another heart canister. Let's put that on straight away. So we've got 15 now. Back to the quest book for the last time today. And let's have a look at what's happened here. We've got famous last words. The one we just unlocked. And it's open. Head first for halos. Hello. And I've got one quest open for completion. Whoa. Where have I got to do? I've got to make seeds of poison, I think is the first one. And I've got to make some squid plant seed, creeper plant seeds, slime plant seed, rain plant seeds, repulsion plant seeds, and flying powder flower seeds. Okay, no problem. Until next time, bye for now.